Greetings painters, welcome to the latest wizard tutorial from Sunny Marsh, the epicentre of watercolour expertise. Tony here, hope you're all well and eager for more wet in wet action. Sounds ghastly, doesn't it? Today it's a snow scene. Here's a picture. Painting I did last year. This is the Julian Alps somewhere in Croatia, I think. It's very simple, and there's only two or three colours, and it's a good study in light and shade. So it's more or less split corner to corner in dark and light. You've got quite a vivid contrast. Even though it's all snow, it's surprising how snow is affected by the lack of light. Sounds obvious, but you don't think of snow like that. There's a huge contrast between snow in the shade, snow in the sun. It's nice composition. It's got these diagonal lines, which I like. Right, enough talking. Let's see how we go. So, as before, I've already penciled it in. It's very simple, I didn't really need to do that. Right, let's get everything ready. Here's my trusty palette. Okay, so I'm going to mix up some French ultramarine and a bit of Payne's grey. That seems crazy, that, for snow, but trust me, it'll be okay. So I'm just going to paint that through. Need a bit more. So just cutting around these rooftops because I want that to be fairly sharp to illustrate the contrast. So you're going to do this fairly quickly, as long as that those lines are still wet. They will disappear. That looks okay. This line here, that one fairly sharp. I'm being careful because this will matter, this particular line. Paper's curling, so I usually spray the back with water. And that should straighten it out. That's a rough edge, it doesn't matter. I'll probably be cropping that off. Okay, so now I want to draw in some even more darker lines to this. Because I discovered when I did the original that that looks quite good. That would be like some natural undulations in the hillside. Going to take out a bit of paint there. A bit more. Okay. I'll let that dry. About 5 minutes. Okay. Happy with that. Straight in. Some trees. So, a bit of Hooker's green. And sepia. Burnt umber would be fine. So, still a little wet. Change brush. Let's find a brush. Oh, that's better. So there's a ridge of pine trees, conifers in the distance. Growing fairly randomly. It's not a plantation. Just vary that colour a little. Now each one would cast its own shadow, of course, so draw that in. Bit of water. Pull that shadow in. So there's a line of trees. Quite extensively down this slope. Bit of burnt sienna mixed into this. Now, most of the trees will be just rough blobs. Just do one or two that are carefully done. I would suggest to the eye that they're all like that. And they've got their own shadows. Okay, So we're 10 minutes in. I'm going to turn you off and do a few more trees. Give me a few minutes. A dry brush. I'm just winging this, I'm not copying anything, so just what seems right. Fancier now. Trees are getting larger now because they're getting closer. Bit of wet in wet action. So these trees are coming behind the rooftops. They will pick out the profile in a quite dramatic style. Brush is running out of paint, which is fine because I want this to fade away a little bit. Just vary the colour a little. Okay. A dry brush on this tree suggests a bit of snow clinging to it, although this may get cropped off. Bit of a path meandering its way down. So it appears over the ridge here. So that suggests there was a missing portion that you can't see. Okay. Wash it in a bit. Okay, enough of this. I'll maybe come back to it. Let's look at these houses. Right. So, this is very rich and dark. Colour here. Right, so it's a bit formulaic, but it's very effective. This erratic dark line is snow that's clinging onto the rooftop. Need a bit of water to lose that edge a little bit. That's fine. Sorry if I've gone quiet, there's nothing much to say here. It's this is sepia, which is the wall. The walls of the houses. My left hand is just a weak. Mix of ultramarine. Take that out a little bit. So the shadow. So all these houses are throwing shadow across the snow. This is fairly random. Notice I just touch into the sepia. Let it drag in. Sepia. That's quite pleasing. So this hillside, this is some sort of raised area, like a patio or something, like decking. Why is this not in sunlight, you're asking? I'm wondering that myself. Okay. So suppose this is roughed up snow. Signs of activity. Bit of a dead area here. I think I may crop that. But I'll make something of it just in case. Let's put some trees on it. Them right at the edge so that if they look rubbish I can cut them off. Right, pay a bit of attention to these trees because they are closer. Shadow. Okay. What are we doing? 22 minutes. We're doing fine. Back to the houses. Don't want to overdo it with lots of detail. There's a line across here, I don't know if it's a wall, must be, or a path. But it looks good on the original, so it's going back in. And that was a hint to another wall. Across this way. Okay. Everything's got its attendant shadow. Shadows are good. I love shadows. Just darken this shadow a bit. I think we're nearly done. I'm just going to darken these fields because I don't want anything to be brighter than these rooftops. So this would dry very much paler, so just bearing that in mind. It also adds a bit of character, you know, rather than just a plain area. Yeah, quite like that. A few random patches. So this is really dark. Massive contrast here. A railing across there. Yes. Keep the kids in. Oh, the little chimneys. I forgot those. All in strange places. And rooftops themselves will have their own shadows. How does that look? Yeah, quite like it. That's the original. What do you think? This has got... There's more detail required here. I don't know. Less is more. Okay. Done. An alpine scene. Hope you like that. 29.5 minutes. I like to keep it to 30 if possible. So happy with that. What can I say? Finished. See you next week. Bye now.